I want to do an experiment. We saw many things doing experiments over the internet. Just I want to flip the bottle. Bear with me if I make 3 or 4 atoms. Okay. What do you think? Is this my luck for the third atom? Or it's my practice?
No.
Mr. Toastmaster, fellow Toastmaster, and guest. Please, was it? What is it? Is it my luck or my work? The way we look at the things defines, controls the events in our life. It influenced me a lot. Let me narrate you a story which tells how I started looking at the things. When I was 6 years old, it was a festive day. My granny asked me to offer a kheer to the god. I took a glass of water with it. My mom, with a soothing voice, "Beta, why is this glass full?" she asked me. Me, with a happy tone, as if my mom forgot something and I'm reminding her. "Mom, God should drink water, right, after eating here." To which each and every member of my 15 members family, that's a huge one, I live in a joint family, everyone couldn't control their laughter. And my mom went into speechless mode. We all know, right, in a typical Indian family, the flow should continue. And here comes my granny with a question. "Have you ever seen God drinking water?" Okay. "Oh, yeah, God will not drink water. But will he have kheer?" And this question made everyone speechless. And my attacks didn't end over there. Probably it was when I was 10 years old. My friends were waiting outside. We want to play a cricket match. I had a very lengthy hair at that time, and this is because of Bangalore effect. And my mom was very busy measuring, comparing the length of my 2 plates. I wonder, due to my intuition or I want to play the match eagerly, I asked her, "Mom, how does it really matter if the both plates are not of equal length?" This question made her very furious, pointing to my father. My father, being the super cool dad ever, he replied, "Of course, yeah, how does it matter?" She just left the place saying, "Okay, even you joined her club, that's great." For me, small misperfections, imperfection, doesn't matter until it affects someone. Then my father continued, you don't have to follow the crowd. You can ask any question at any time to anyone. Probably, this might not fit you into that moment, but that doesn't mean you're wrong. I have grown up with this added thought. And our perceptions to the same event may vary from person to person. I strongly agree with that. During my college days, everyone was busy with the placements. Absolute silence in the classroom. So was I, preparing, turning the notes. I was really busy. Yet, I got distracted with the bird's flight, moving forth and back in the classroom. I noticed it was carrying a twig in its beak. Oh, wonder, what is it for? I started monitoring that. I saw it was trying to build a beautiful nest at the top of the ventilator. I kept on monitoring that. Each time the twig fell down to the floor, it started picking it back to the ventilator. It failed N times before giving its best. And at the end of 1 hour, it built really a beautiful one. The deepest feeling always shows itself in silence. And it taught me never to give up. And patience is much needed to get into your nest. In the meantime, the girl sitting next to me, she was saying, why is it struggling so hard to build a nest? It could just sit in the ventilator and live. See, there are two different perceptions for the same event. Perceptions sometimes may vary, sometimes may go wrong, sometimes may be different from exactly different from person to person. I'm happy with the way I look at the things. How we perceive the things defines what we are and who we are. I conclude by saying that change the way you look at the things. The things you look at will change. Thank you.